Hello, dear students. Здравствуйте, студенты. My name is Вероника. Меня зовут Вероника. And I am a professional Russian teacher. Already 7 years I teach Russian to foreigners in one of private institutes in Moscow. And I have to say that I do love my profession because I think it's really interesting and important, yeah. So today at this Russian lesson, I would like to teach you how to use our Russian prepositions and Russian cases too. And I will be reading all the phrases 2 times. First time slowly as a Russian teacher, second time fast as a Russian native speaker. And we will start with the preposition na. It has a lot of different meanings, so let's start. Я иду на оперу. Я иду на оперу. Here we used accusative case because here is the idea of movement from one place, for example, from home to opera. Yeah. If you have idea of movement, you have to use accusative normally. And why did we use the preposition na? Because in Russian language, opera is not a place. A place is the theater. But opera, it is an event. So when you have event in Russian language, you have to use the preposition na. Number 2. Сейчас мой брат на уроке. Сейчас мой брат на уроке. Here we used prepositional case because he is already at the lesson. He is already in class. He doesn't move from one place to another. He is already there. In this situation, we use prepositional and we used here na because we are talking again about event. So урок, lesson, class, it is event in Russian, and school, it is a location, a place. Yeah. Number 3. Он смотрит на девушку. Here we use accusative case because it is direct object. He looks at the girl, and we use на, because in Russian language we have one word, смотреть. It can mean to watch and to look at. And смотреть, only if we add на, it means he looks at. Without adding this на, this preposition, it means watch. For example, он смотрит телевизор. Without preposition на, it means he watches TV. But he looks at the girl, you need to add this preposition на. Он смотрит на девушку. Number 4. Ручка на столе. Ручка на столе. Here we used prepositional case because it is a location, yeah? Ручка где? На столе. Again, no idea of movement, it just lays on the table. And if you talk about something, for example, тетрадь, copybook, карандаш, pencil, карандаш на тетради. If you talk something is on the top of something or on the surface of something, you have to use this preposition на. Okay, so now let's move on to the next one. It is the preposition в. Number 1. Ключ в сумке. Here we use preposition because we prepositional case because we talk about the location, because we talk about the place. Ключ в сумке. But We used this preposition в because it is not on the top, like I was talking with a pencil. It is inside the bag. If it is, if something is inside something, you have to use prepositional case and в this preposition. Also, if you talk about movement, right? Я иду в театр. Я иду в театр. Also, you can use в this preposition here, but it must be not an event. It must be a place, because театр, it's a place, and you can go there. So you use with the idea of movement, accusative, and the preposition в. And number three, мы живем в Москве. Мы живем в Москве. So we live inside of Moscow, right? That's why we use preposition. And again, we use preposition в and prepositional case. Джон влюбился в Анну. Джон влюбился в Анну. Also, we have some different verbs that require to use after them some special preposition. If you talk about this verb влюбился, you need to use в after it. So if you want to say fell in love, you don't say with in Russian, you say in, kind of different thing. С. I know that most probably beginners in Russian language, they know that с means with, but this is not only meaning. So let's start. Number one. Мария гуляет с Сергеем. Мария гуляет с Сергеем. Here it's very easy, the same like in English. Мария walks with Сергей. And we use с and instrumental case. The same number two. Чай с лимоном. Tea with lemon. Also, you use с and instrumental. If you have this idea, something plus something, something with something, you have to use с and instrumental case. But also, if you talk about time, you have to use с and, be careful, not instrumental, but genitive. So, с понедельника Антон будет работать в новой фирме. С понедельника Антон будет работать в новой фирме. So if you talk about weeks, days, hours, months, year, you can use с, means from Monday, from September, с сентября, с этой недели, from this week, с этого года, from this year, for example. And also we can use с in the meaning from, but we are talking about event. Студент ушел с урока. Студент ушел с урока. So, yeah, if you are talking about event and movement from, you can use с. The same with the opera. Я ушла с оперы. I left the opera. Or Джон ушел с работы. Работа in Russian is also event. So John left the job or the office today, yeah. The preposition от also has some different meanings. First one that most probably all Russian beginners know. Он пришел от друга. he came from a friend or he came from a friend's place. I'm not sure about the translation. If you are talking about a person, be very careful. A person, not a place, only a person, and movement from, you can use от. So, он пришел от друга, от подруги, от сестры, от доктора, от директора. All of them are people, yeah? So, we have to use от and genitive. And also, another, the second expression is very interesting. Мы устали от тебя. Мы устали от тебя. We are tired of you. Kinda, you are the reason why we are tired. If you talk about reason, you can use от, this preposition от, plus genitive case. For example, от тебя. От ветра, because of the wind. От жары, because of the heat. От, what else? От, because of rain, от дождя. And many other different reasons you can imagine. К, also very important preposition. Лена пошла к врачу. Лена пошла к врачу. If we talk about movement from one place to another, for example, Лена was at home and then she decided to go to the doctor, but the doctor is a person. So here you must use the preposition к only with people. Лена пошла к врачу. So, and you have to use dative case here. If you talk about place, you use the preposition в. If you talk about event, you have to use the preposition на. If you talk about people, you say the preposition к. I hope that you understand this topic. If you don't understand or you have some questions what I'm talking about, please let me know. Just write me some questions in the comments below. I will read and definitely I will answer. Also, we use this preposition к as a part of the expression. For example, к счастью, fortunately. К несчастью, unfortunately. Also, we have к сожалению, like unfortunately. I'm not sure that I pronounced this word correctly, but I hope you can understand. Also, we can use the preposition к in this expression. Вы подошли к дому. Also, we use here dative case. Вы подошли к дому. If you are talking about movement and you reached the house, but you didn't enter, you are just standing nearby and don't go inside, you say к. You see, here in Russian language, we have a lot of different ideas, a lot of different shades of the words, and they are all reflected in our language. Isn't it interesting? Из. Мужчина вышел из магазина. Мужчина вышел из магазина. Here we use genitive case. And if we are talking about movement from some place, some location, we have to use is. So be careful again. If we are talking about place and movement from, we say is. If we are talking about event and movement from, we have to use с. If we are talking about a person and movement from, we have to use the preposition к. Easy, yeah? And also I wrote some expression It's not very common, but quite useful. Он вышел из себя. Он вышел из себя. He lost his temper. The literal meaning, he exited from himself. Yeah, he is not himself now. Yeah, he behaves like someone else. Он вышел из себя. Another very important preposition, для. Для. It's very tricky, especially for English-speaking people, because sometimes in English you use this preposition for, and in Russian, in this situation, we do not say for. For example, I work in institute for 3 years. Here we say no preposition at all. We do not say anything. Я работаю в институте 3 года. We do not say four here. Okay, let's move on to my examples. Эта тема слишком трудная для него. Эта тема слишком трудная для него. So here you have this preposition for in English and in Russian. And with the preposition для, we always use genitive. Another one. Это важно для меня. Это важно для меня. It's important for me. Also, we use для in genitive case. Без. Без. It's an antonym for с. С means with. Без means without. Вы пьете кофе без сахара? Вы пьете кофе без сахара? So, with this preposition без, you have to use genitive case. And без always means without, no other meaning. Number two. Невозможно жить без интернета. Невозможно жить без интернета. Again, без means without, and интернета is in genitive case because of this preposition. Перед. This preposition has some different meanings. So, first one means in front of. Я вижу красивый сад перед твоей школой. Я вижу красивый сад перед твоей школой. Перед here means in front of, and after this preposition, we have to use instrumental case. Because this preposition перед is kind of a trigger for this case. When you see перед, you think, okay, instrumental, I know. Учитель поговорил с мальчиком перед уроком. Учитель поговорил с мальчиком перед уроком. Here is again the idea is very similar. So the teacher talked to the boy before the class. But as I can see, these prepositional meanings, like in front of and before, there is some similar idea, right? But once in front of, перед, we are talking about the place, and перед, if we are talking about before, we talk about the time, but the idea is very similar, I think. Над, above. Яркая картина висит над столом. Яркая картина висит над столом. Here my translator suggested me to translate over. I'm not sure. I would say above the table. If I'm not correct, just let me know. So if you have this idea above, you have to use not plus instrumental case. And number two, мы работаем над этим. Мы работаем над этим. So we are working on it. After the preposition над, you can use again instrumental, and if you are talking about the verb работаем, somehow we need this. Мы работаем над ошибками. We work on our mistakes. Мы работаем над этим проектом. We are working on this project. Yeah. Another one is again antonym. Под. Над. Под. Yeah. Над. Above. Под. Под. Under. So, красивая рыжая кошка сидит под столом. Красивая рыжая кошка сидит под столом. So, after preposition под, again, the prepositions in Russian language, they are not very individual words, so they do not have a lot of stress on them. That's why we do not say под, but we say под столом. It's like one word together, под столом, yeah. So под means under, and you use instrumental. После, very useful. После ужина он гулял в парке 2 часа. После ужина он гулял в парке 2 часа. После means after. And after this, you have to use genitive case. And be careful. In English, I think you can use... you can use this after, like after verbs. After he ate his dinner, he started to walk, yeah? In Russian, this construction is tricky, and I would say после того, как он поужинал. So if you want to use after with the preposition, you need this construction после того, как, because you cannot say после он поужинал. It sounds weird and very like foreign person is speaking them. So be careful. Now we move on to до. До. Some different meanings. Таксист ехал до офиса 20 минут. Таксист ехал до офиса 20 минут. Да, here we need to use after this genitive case. And he kind of, I would translate this, he reached the office for 20 minutes, in 20 minutes, yeah. So do, if we are talking about movement from one place to another, and you finally reached the destination, you use do. Позвони мне до собрания. Позвони мне до собрания. Call me before the meeting. So if you are talking about the time and you want to say before, you can use two prepositions, перед or до. They are kind of very synonymous. How you say this? Yeah, synonymous in this situation. О. Мы общаемся по скайпу. Мы общаемся по скайпу. If you are talking about these communication things like Zoom, Skype, WhatsApp, Facebook, so you can say по. Like via, you say по. And you use data case. The same if we are talking about my profession. Я веду уроки по Zoom. Я веду уроки по Zoom. I teach via Zoom, or I teach Zoom classes. Here, again, we use по Zoom, and dative case, of course. And if we are talking about some studies, у меня есть вопрос по грамматике. У меня есть вопрос по грамматике. Here we use dative case and the preposition по. Not a, not about, but по. Вопрос по. You just need to remember this construction in your head. And number four. Учебник по математике. If we are talking about studies, учебник по математике, учебник по литературе, like literature textbook, учебник по русскому языку, Russian language textbook. You just need to remember that you have to say book, по, and the subject in dative case. Okay. Около. Около. Near. Парень ждет тебя около ресторана. Парень ждет тебя около ресторана. So after около we have to use genitive case, and it's very easy, I think, to remember. But remember that you cannot say just he lives nearby, kinda. Он живет около. It sounds very strange, very weird. I mean, you have to say около, and then you have to say near what? Около школы, около магазина, около дома. But just to say only около, like he lives nearby, it's strange and not clear what you mean. What do you mean? За, за. It's very interesting. So we have three meanings, I think. Yeah, three. Спасибо за урок. Thank you for the lesson. Here you say thank you for something. It's an object, right? Спасибо за урок. That's why you use accusative and the preposition за. Number two. Он пошел за цветами. Он пошел за цветами. Here you use instrumental case. And it's you use here за because you are talking about target. If you are talking about target, you have to use the preposition за. Он пошел за хлебом. He went to buy some bread. Он пошел за молоком. He went to buy some milk. So if you have some target, or он пошел за деньгами в банк. He went to the bank to take some money. Yeah? That's it. Also, we can use the preposition за if we talk about location. Твоя машина стоит за домом. За means behind. So you remember that we have the preposition перед in front of, and the antonym would be за, behind. Твоя машина стоит за домом. I would translate this phrase like I parked your car behind the house. Or super important. Or means about. Number one. Я думаю о тебе. Я думаю о тебе. I'm thinking about you. Or I think of you. And number two. Он мечтает об отпуске. Он мечтает об отпуске. He dreams of a vacation. But here I wrote the question mark because I'm not sure. In Russian, dreams means he has a dream, he wants something. Not like he's sleeping and he's thinking about vacation while he's sleeping, but he just wants to have some vacation, yeah? So we have some different verbs, for example, думать, to think, мечтать, to dream, рассказывать, to tell, спорить, to argue. And after them, and many others, we have to use this preposition or, and normally we use, not normally, always we use prepositional case. У меня будет вечеринка сегодня. У меня будет вечеринка сегодня. У меня, it means I have. For example, у меня есть машина. I have a car. У меня есть карандаш. I have a pencil. У меня есть блокнот. I have a... У меня есть тетрадь. I have a copybook. So, if you are talking about having something or having someone, for example, you say у меня. The same, I have a boyfriend. У меня есть парень. I have a girlfriend. У меня есть девушка. And if you are talking about the location, you also can use this preposition у. Сестра стоит у окна. Сестра стоит у окна. Kind of very similar to the word near, около. Sister stands at the window, near the window, close to the window. This idea, yeah? Через. Here we talk about time. Фильм начнется через час. Here you have to use accusative case. And через means in, sometime. It's connected with future. Я вернусь через минуту. Я вернусь через минуту. Again, accusative case, and we are talking about future. I'll be back in a minute. Also, I didn't write this, but if you are talking about movement and you cross something, for example, мальчик идет через дорогу. So he crosses the road. So you can use через too. There is no connection with time. It's only location and crossing something. Okay, my dear Russian learners, this was the last preposition for today. And if you want to know some other things about some other Russian prepositions, just let me know in the comments below. I will read and answer. And if you have any other idea about Russian phonetics, yeah, I always say something wrong with this word, Russian phonetics, yeah, Russian cases, Russian words, just let me know and I will make a video for you. Увидимся скоро. See you soon. Пока-пока. Have a nice day. And study Russian. Изучайте русский язык.